You'll pay nothing unless there's a recovery in your favor. Call now for a free consultation at 800-716-0457. You must protect your legal rights. Call 800-716-0457. Again, 800-716-0457. 75 candles on his birthday cake, but Smokey the Bear hopes none of them start a forest fire.
The icon of the longest-running public service campaign in the United States turned 75 years old this week.
Is that a little professional jealousy there, PSA man?
U.S. Forest Service and National Association of State Foresters have planned weekend-long birthday parties all across America. Smokey the Bear was born August 9th, 1944, and the Ad Council agreed that he
gets here early to get set up for the fire prevention campaign. He goes, lights are live. He's like, oh my.
Smokey's anniversary comes as scientists warn the world's forests are vulnerable amid climate change.
Well, that's for the people in Brazil and Argentina.
Jeffrey Epstein's suicide yesterday morning almost immediately launched new conspiracy theories online.
How come they don't
President
say
Trump
alleged?
Retweeted one person who
doesn't say alleged.
They're supposed to say
himself.
Alleged.
Yeah.
It's not confirmed yet that that was a suicide.
If you can't
until they have video of him doing
messages
it,
for you, yeah, how would you like to have a large portion of your
credit
card bill
and
medical bills
say
and department store debt forgiven? National Credit Card Relief would like to give you free information on the forgiveness program.
Maybe this is one of
you. Millions in unsecured debt. It's not bankruptcy. It's not consolidation. This special program actually wipes clean the part of your debt that is forgiven from what you owe your creditors. Call for free information and get all your questions answered in the first free call. The more you owe, the more you can save.
They haven't shown any video of the ambulance backed up to the jail.
This debt forgiveness program can be very effective. Call for free information and find out more now. 800-291-6670. There is no cost or obligation for the information. Don't wait. Call 800-291-6670. That's 800-291-6670. Get your debt problem solved. Call 800-291-6670 today.
Or you're absolutely right.
You can have my eyelash. Here 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 you can have my
$20.
With temperatures around 90 degrees. Tonight, a few evening thunderstorms, lows in the low 70s.
Prolific serial killer and serial killer in New York City.
Go back to sleep, FM Talk 106.5. The Gulf Coast.
Morning, John.
Stand by.
Whether you're in search of a great new bottle of wine or you want a rundown of the best brunch spots in the area, Mike and Stu have the answer.
Almost
with a combined half century in the industry, they bring their wealth of experience to bring you the latest trends, expert opinions, and interviews with people in the know. They are the dynamic duo of dining.
It's a wine and food show, Stu. It's a food and wine show, trust me. Look right here, it's Sip and Chew. It's wine and food. Because Chew rhymes with Stew, that's the only reason.
You glorified fried
food. Mike, you're hot.
Great killer.
Now it's time to Sip and Chew with Mike and Stu on FM Talk 106.5.
Well, good morning. Good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So hot.
And only you can prevent forest fires.
I tell you, you know,
happy birthday, Smokey.
Happy birthday, Smokey.
And Michael Bailey.
I didn't know Smokey was a Leo like me.
You and Smokey turned 75 the same
week.
Well,
I didn't turn 75, but
you're working on it.
Okay, 85 in the same week.
Okay, whatever. So, yeah. Hey, see what I got? See what Luann got me for my birthday?
The Alabama shirt?
No.
The necklace?
My frying pans.
Oh, yeah, the Blue Diamond, right?
My Blue Diamond frying pans, man. I used it last night on steak. Mm.
be one of the best things you ever make an omelet with.
What's significant about Blue Diamond?
Well, I went and looked at the ones like Stu's got. What do you got?
Gotham.
I guess there's this big connection with Walmart and Gotham Steel and the World Food Championship and Sip and Chew and all this. But I was looking at it, and they don't have the reinforced bottom like the Blue Diamond does. The Blue Diamond's got a thicker layer of reinforcement on the bottom of the pan, so it doesn't warp. So
mine ain't warped.
Huh? I'm just saying, you buy those so cheap. Everybody, you go out and buy these cheap Teflon frying pans, and after they receive some really good hot heat on them, they start warping on the bottom, and then they sit there and wobble on you.
And Teflon starts disappearing, too.
I tell you something else about Teflon. You're never supposed to cook on it higher than medium heat, because if you do, it starts putting off some ionized particles or something that causes flu-like symptoms in small children, pets, and the elderly. That means you can't ever get the Maillard reaction.
That explains my nasal drip.
That explains mine too. But yeah, I've tried to get away from Teflon, and somewhere I've got some nice restaurant frying pans. They don't have any Teflon in it. You just got to keep them clean and
stainless steel.
Let me ask both of y'all this question, because there are some skillets out there and pots and pans, but skillets particularly, that have those rings around underneath that's supposed to more evenly distribute the heat. Is that a myth also?
Only thing in my opinion really equally distributes the heat is copper.
It's the alloy.
And the burner on your stove.
Yeah, cast iron.
Yeah. Anodized aluminum is very good at that too, but that doesn't look like regular aluminum. It feels like cast iron.
Yeah.
It's very heavy, cannot go in a dishwasher, it'll ionize if you do.
And should everybody have an iron skillet in their repertoire?
Yes, one of every size.
Hey, I've got that little cast iron cornbread maker. You make the little cornbreads that look like little corn stalks, corn, you know?
That's actually a corn pone.
A corn pone?
Yeah, it's pone when it's shaped like that.
Okay, I love
it. So that's for use in the oven or on the stovetop?
Instead of making cornbread. Somewhere in my storage units, I've got my...
Well, wait a minute. It's not doing you any good in the storage.
I don't have enough room in my little
palatial pad.
I don't have enough room.
In your back.
Now that I've got another creature living there, a little kitty cat.
I was going to say, talking about your friend.
Well, you'd be happy to know that though we haven't brought a cat home, we have named the cat.
Okay.
Escher.
Oh, I like that. Now, that's a classy name.
He's a black and white little kitty, and M.C. Escher is my favorite artist.
Oh, okay.
And most of his work is black and white.
And you know, the cat might accept that name in the secret cat world.
Well,
because I hear they have their own names.
Who's the artist that did I Spy, You Spy?
I don't know. I've never heard of it.
It's in Mad Magazine.
Oh, okay.
Good Spy, Bad Spy.
It would be Mad Magazine.
Somebody's the artist.
Yeah. Well, I think
he's a black and white artist. Yeah. So, well, that's a good name.
You mean Spy versus Spy?
Is it Spy versus Spy? Yeah. It's been a long time.
Yeah, apparently. Yeah. I remember suffering through that magazine every month when it would come through just so I could do the little pull apart puzzle thing. They had different images because I was too young.
What, me worry?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was my motto for years.
So
we got a busy day. Let's talk about who we got coming on. First, you got a guest.
Yeah, we got John Weichman coming in.
Legend.
He's got something important to tell us. And I saw a box in his hand, too. It looks like he's going to feed us.
We do
take bribes.
Yeah, yeah. We'll be on the air. Just bring some food. Throw some kibble at us.
There you go.
And then at the bottom of the hour, we're going to visit with Mikey Chen, who has Strictly Dumpling, which is one of my new binges on the online. He's made several hundred videos.
Oh, really?
Traveling around the world.
He's like a Bobby Flay. You know, Bobby Flay, before Food Network, he had already had like 100 videos out of him barbecuing.
Oh, I didn't know that.
You didn't know that?
No. Yeah.
I still think we need a tailgate show coming up sometime.
We're going to do something.
Soon. Oh, yeah.
We're going to do something.
Yeah. How about you contact some of your friends over at Southern Mississippi, see if they'll host us there, Charlie?
Well, there's a thought.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I got to call them anyhow to buy some tickets. So.
Yeah. You know, I'm excited about football season right around the corner. Yeah, yeah, I see you got your Atlanta Braves shirt on. Well, it's got the Atlanta logo on it.
That is not the Atlanta logo.
That is the Atlanta Braves logo and has been for 75 years.
You're
just because you left the blue trim off of it.
I'm sorry, but Alabama, University of Alabama's
older. Oh, I thought that was Arkansas.
Older.
No, Arkansas shirt Atlanta is Braves, a little
but
darker.
Not that logo. That logo is about 15 years old with the University
of Alabama. And Mississippi State is even darker. They're almost purple.
Yeah.
Violet.
Oh, so you were saying?
Yeah, we were talking about your Braves shirt.
the Browns won the other night.
It's a preseason game.
I know it. Saints suck, though.
I know people that bet on preseason games.
I wouldn't even pay to go to a game.
No, because they're trying out plays.
Yeah.
They're reevaluating or doing final evaluations on a number of new players.
They and we'll bet weeks. Spreads.
Huh?
And we'll bet spreads.
Yeah.
Why? Why?
Well, I just getting warmed up. Just getting warmed up.
They're practicing betting.
Yeah, they're practicing how to call their bookie, I guess.
I still haven't figured out how to do all that stuff. You know, all the casinos have those betting things, and you see a wall full of screens and all kind of numbers and all of that, and if I want to bet, I want to bet, you know, who's going to win, who's going to lose.
Just go hang out with Danny Sheridan one day over there.
I don't like the whole idea of gambling because I can't afford to lose the money.
Yeah.
So I just don't.
But people who gamble love the idea.
Yeah, well.
Probably a good thing you're not on the board.
I think every state should have gambling anywhere you want it, anytime you want it.
Mississippi's
it makes
ready,
no sense.
And Mississippi's getting ready to do the, where you can go buy Powerball tickets and Mega Million tickets. And here we are in little Alabama fighting over a toll.
Paying for the educations of every public school student in Florida, Georgia, Tennessee, and Mississippi.
No, sir. Yep. And Louisiana, too.
Yeah. Well, and they're not bordering us.
And
I know, but there's still people will go to New Orleans. And
no, people go to New Orleans.
And get their tickets while they're there.
Mm. And do and participate in Vice, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I've never heard of such a thing.
But, anywho, and they'll eat at the restaurants there while they're there, too.
Mm.
I know I always try to find something new
mm-hmm.
when I'm over in Louisiana.
You know what I really worry about, though, is that with legalized betting all over the country, put $100,000 into some athlete's families to maybe miss a pass every once in a while so the point spread is guaranteed. How are you going to keep that from happening?
They do. Basketball is the easiest one to manipulate.
Yeah.
And in my opinion, has been rigged since the early 90s.
Well, so I mean, yeah. You know, and I, because if it happens, you
and
know, it's going to be it's going to be
an NBA official has already admitted under oath that the commissioner has called them up during games and told them who's supposed to win the game. So if they're going to rig it.
You're talking basketball.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Back in the 90s. So if the NBA is going to rig their own games, why shouldn't the refs be allowed to, or the players be allowed to? It's a,
I just think it's a potential threat to sports. Period.
Yeah,
there's too much basketball on TV.
There's none on TV right now.
Yes, there is.
There's way too much baseball on TV.
Y'all see.
Anytime there's any baseball on TV, there's way too much baseball.
There's tons of basketball. This is
summer leagues, European.
Oh my God, it's ridiculous.
Are we getting ready to have?
They gotta have something to put on.
Well, we gotta put on a commercial, Mike. So.
Or something. Well, folks, when we come back, we're going to have John Weichman with us.
Yeah.
I've known John a long time.
Well, you've been around a long time.
You have to call him, or is he calling us?
He's right here in the lobby.
He's in the lobby.
Well, somebody go tell him to come on in.
We will, since we're on commercial break. 343-0106.
And glad to have you. There too.
Glad to have you all with us this morning.
Call the things there.
All right. 60 donuts. You're going to
have to go around.
All right. Thank you. 60 donuts?
A bottle of red. Y'all decide how you're going to work this. Okay. You want
me to just pop out and let you use the mic for a
second?
We can do that.
All right.
Go get a donut.
She will move the donut. You getting sound okay?
I have the donuts.
You hear?
Oh, yeah.
We're good.
A bottle of whites.
It's here.
Pensacola Bay Center is proud to present one of your very favorite bands, Widespread.
Go check out the blog, y'all. Down there at the bottom, the part right there.
Widespread Panic with two shows, Saturday, August 31st, and Sunday, September 1st.
And FM 1065
is giving away tickets to the Sunday show every day on Mobile Mornings for Mobile. It's your chance to win tickets to see Widespread Panic at Pensacola Bay Center on FM Talk 1065.
Calm down, Phil. Calm down.
No, it's my way of showing my appreciation to Jack Green for saving me so much money on my insurance.
Sounds like it's coming from a storage room.
Don't go in there.
This is a restaurant. Dolphins is doing a thing for the two-ball police officers next Sunday, too.
I'm sick to death of seeing that lizard on TV telling me what to do with my 15 minutes.
Dolphins are trying to do it.
Jokes on him, because that's exactly how long it took me to string him up by the kookaburras.
Jack Green is not going to appreciate this one bit.
Sure he will. I'm his spokesperson. Oh, be quiet and eat your house flies. Call the Jack Green Insurance Agency today and find out how you can save money on your auto, all types of commercial equipment and business insurance. Ask about wind coverage, too. It's likely you're paying way too much.
That's what I'm all about, saving people money on
that. You just need to worry about saving oxygen right now, sweetheart.
Jack Green Insurance Agency in Mobile.
Ask for Jack.
314-5393. Paid not attorney spokesperson, First Nakawani with Principal Office in Dallas, Texas. Attention landscapers and anyone working in the landscape industry. This is an important alert for users of the weed killer Roundup that have been diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. A California jury recently awarded $289 million to a landscaper who claimed Roundup gave him cancer. Roundup is the most widely used herbicide in the United States with billions of pounds applied each year. Farm workers and landscapers are at the highest risk of injury from exposure. Time is limited to file a claim. If you work with Roundup weed killer and were diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, don't wait for Roundup legal helpline now. The number to dial is 800-951-6265. That number again is 800-951-6265. You can be entitled to significant compensation. If you've been exposed to Roundup and have been diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, don't wait. Call the Roundup legal helpline right now. 800-951-6265. That's 800-951-6265.
Again,
800-951-6265. Call now.
Yeah,
I am. Leading educator.
30 seconds, dude.
CBD products.
Who's staying out there?
She's on a mission to change the way we look at cannabis. Jennifer Boozer presents Sweet Home Cannabama, a show that'll answer all your questions, provide accurate information, and dispel the myths of CBD. With guests from every corner of the hemp industry.
Welcome to the show, John.
Jennifer leads the discussion of all things cannabis in Alabama. Join Jennifer Boozer every Monday at 7 p.m. for Sweet Home Cannabama on FM Talk 106.5. Get on the line. Call 343-0106. Now, back to Mike and Stu.
Chef Rob, the Irish Pub and Grill. You're listening to Ben Chu with Mike and Stu.
Mics are hot.
Okay, we're here with someone I've known for a pretty good long time. Used to make some good money off of him when selling him good wine back in the days. But I got next to me is John Weichman. And a lot of people pronounce your last name incorrect. And I've always used to call you Weichman, but it's Weichman, isn't it?
Yeah, the family calls it like the Halloween witch, like a W-I-T. It's a German name, but it's just one of those things that's the way we learned it coming up. And as long as you call me to dinner, I don't care what you call me.
So how you been, John?
Doing fine, thank you. Friday night, I was involved in planning and producing a dinner, five-course dinner for 200 people for the Catholic Archdiocese for their seminarians fundraiser. Alec Naaman and I worked together on that, and his chef, Tom. And just last Saturday and Sunday, I was doing with our chaplain at the police and fire department a family picnic for Mobile Police and Fire and out there at Camp Grace. So I still tend to get in the kitchen.
Yeah, yeah. It's in your blood, isn't it?
Yeah, and I think it's a mental disease.
people keep soon going back to it, you know. Yeah. At least I know that they could fall on that. So,
well, when you leave a career of chemical engineering to serve people rather than pipes and pumps or something, there it is.
Well, tell us what got you up so early this morning and brought you to the station.
Well, thank you. A year ago, the chief of police, Batiste, asked me to come on board a year ago December to do a fundraiser for the Mobile Police Department Foundation, the Mobile Law Enforcement Foundation, and we had a great gala there at Fort Whiting, and raised some money for that to help officers, etc. The deal is these foundations, it's not that the city doesn't take care of their own, but there's always unexpected costs. And there's things come down the pike after budgets are set and such. Right. And just, you know, you just want to be able to have a source to get some quick approval for monies to do things, whether it be for SWAT or whatever, your vice. But so we had a great win on that. This year I decided that I, as an individual, as a graduate of the Mobile Citizen Police Academy and one of the founders of the Alumni Association, to take and try to encompass all first responders. By that I mean fire, rescue, as well as police, and also a new organization formed by some people in the police department that is dedicated to helping family of the fallen, those that lost a husband or son or whatever in the line of duty, and even some of those that, you know, lost it some time back, you know, help them with financial and other assistance. So this is a great deal. You know, Texas de Brazil has just opened the door of hospitality for us, and it's going to be Sunday the 18th from noon to 3.
Mm-hmm.
They have this fabulous self-serve salad bar, about 50 items, everything from prosciutto and smoked salmon and shrimp to vegetables, cheeses, charcuterie, and then you got 9 hot items, again, self-service bar, everything from lobster bisque to seafood dish to potatoes au gratin. But then the real fun is when the gauchos start coming out with their sabers with the meat that has been slow roasted in the true Brazilian style over wood charcoal that rotates, and they're going to have everything from lamb to chicken to filet to a couple cuts of Brazilian beef to Brazilian sausage. You know, so it's, I mean, and for $50 a person, or $75 if you want to do adult beverages. These are legal donations. You can take those off as tax donations to the organizations. You will, you know, have the meal of your life. We've got a musician coming in again from New Orleans that does a great job for some of my other events. But tickets are limited, and so we hope, you know, with the support of, you know, News 5, this station, and Lamar Advertising, put up beautiful digital billboards for us. I mean, we want the public to know that this is an opportunity to support all first responders and have a great, great return on your investment immediately with the food opportunity, but knowing too that you're helping three organizations that really are all care about those that, as we say, supporting those that answer the call. Because they answer the call night or day.
Well, they do do that. That is for sure. So, I mean, that's actually a great bargain, but it's in the middle of the day, which that's fine.
Yeah, they open up on Sundays at 4:00, so we had to find the window that wouldn't interfere, because, you know, they're donating everything.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you know, they are really, their owner, based out of Dallas, he says, no, we don't want them to pay anything. You know, we want to support these first responders, Mobile. So you just, you know, let them enjoy this as if they were a paying guest, but we're not going to take their money at all. It's going to go to the funds of the three organizations.
Oh, wow. That's unbelievable. That's nice. Yeah. Super them. You know, I've never eaten here. Have you eaten there?
One time. Okay. You know, and it's, you know, it's, Mobile is really, I think, truly only international restaurant, just because everything on the menu is representative of how they would do it in Brazil or Argentina. Mm-hmm. But, you know, this particular one, they associated with Brazil. But I've had several opportunities to go to Buenos Aires, and that's where I first saw this in the windows. You go down one of these little areas, and they got the rotisseries with the meat there going over the coals. And but it's the real deal. And, I mean, like I say, it's all tax deductible. Their normal price is very reasonable, $41.99, and that includes, you know, all the cold, all the hot, much meat. They're never going to stop coming by and say, would you like some more meat?
And that's then, how they do it.
Yeah.
It's that way in places I've been to in Europe and South America, particularly in Brazil, in Argentina.
Yeah, and they're also, if we have involved in this meal, you'll have a choice of either bananas, foster pie, or a key lime pie. and then you got your tea and such. If you do the $75 ticket, mm-hmm. then you're going to have access to, you know, top of the line spirits, their own brand of wines that they bring in, mostly Chilean wines. That's their house wine. With, and then also they got the beers, including a couple beers from Brazil. So it's a real international experience for a great cause. There's going to be good people there that's supporting it. We hope to have a fire engine out front and have, you know, a SWAT vehicle and such. It's designed basically for adults, though children, you know, 12 or older would be welcome. We just want to be sure everybody's relaxed and just enjoying and thinking about the good thing they're doing.
You're talking about Mobile's probably only international restaurant. I remember Eight Kings, when Eight Kings used to be around.
Yes.
And that goes way back.
Mr. Costaritas. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, he was they had a great deli. I remember that, Eight Kings and that deli there at Bel Air Mall. Yeah, that was ahead of the curve at that time.
Right, right. Well, you know, we come on here and we support local. We talk about doing local, be local. But there's a lot of chain-type places that do a good job for the community
as well.
And this is one of those opportunities.
Yeah, they are. They're in 9 countries, and they've got 65 restaurants. But, you know, they're sort of a niche of their own, like a Ruth's Chris, which, you know, those are probably the two as far as chains, multi-units. But, no, we're blessed that, you know, Mobile does a good job of calling out the products that aren't good. So if a chain comes in here and doesn't do a good product, a couple of 3 years,
they don't stay long,
do they? Leave town with their tail between their legs.
They don't stay long. So give us some more information, give us some details on how they can get a hold of you and how websites or Facebook page.
Mm-hmm. They're more than welcome to call the Texas D Brazil number at 447-0777 and make the reservation and pay at the time they come in. Or they can call me at 401-7246. And again, I'm taking down names and you know, reservations. So it's...
One.
It is a, you know, reservation only, just because they only have 170 seats and we don't want anybody to just show up and not be able to experience it. But if you want to come at 1:30 instead of 12, you know, we're going to be open. We hope to get some turnover. Yes.
Right.
Yes. Serve more than 175 people, just because of the cause and all that's been put into it.
Well, that's
media.
A great deal. Even with the wine, paying the $75 and getting the wine or the beverages.
No, it's the $50 or $70 with tax and gratuity, and the $75, $100 with tax and gratuity type of thing. So, again, you figure the 30% tax deduction next year,
and it's going to a great cause.
Yes, very much so. Our first responders, and hope to do this once a year because there's always a need. Hopefully it's just to continue to provide them with means to have better training or equipment that they need, not for memorial services.
Yeah. Well, John, thank you for getting up early this morning and coming on the show. And thank you for the donuts.
Yeah, well, you're a very gracious host tonight. Pleasure to see you again, Mike.
Good to see you, John. John Weichman. Very iconic name in Mobile, in the restaurant industry.
Yes, sir. Everybody of my generation.
John, do you have a sheet that has the details?
This right here.
Yes, sir. I wanted to do a PSA for it.
You're one in this folder here.
Yeah, but that's not my folder.
No. Oh, okay.
Did a good job this morning.
Need a donut? We got some.
No.
Mike and Chen next, y'all.
Yeah, I talked to him in Phil's office.
Mike and Chen, Strictly Dumpling coming up.
This information update brought to you by the Craig Smith Agency. Time to review your auto and homeowners coverage and find out what the Craig Smith Agency can offer with some of the most competitive
and best
miles
offered
on the market today. Call 626-2500 or at their new location.
Just leave one.
Yeah, it was two.
Okay.
Hey John, have you been on our morning? Things were settled the old-fashioned way. Which cheese, we believe it should be that way again. Just you and our soon-to-be-famous sandwich burger. Piled high with bacon, cheese, lettuce, tomato, onion, and pickles. Or just the way you like it. It's time for a showdown. Butch Cassidy's Old Shady with Florida Street. This information update brought to you by your city license. Your pizza, your burger, your chicken patty, 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 your chic
Find out who our readers think is the best locally.
We're coming back, guys. Let it go. Call me shot 20 seconds.
You scratch, climb, and claw their way to the very top. Also, in this issue, you'll find all of the usual news, commentary, cuisine, sports, and arts and entertainment coverage you've come to expect from the state's largest locally owned newspaper. So pick up Lanyap today or head over to lanyapmobile.com and become a digital subscriber and help keep Mobile and the Nappy Spunky. Nappy time. Nappy time. That's right. To get on the line, call 343-0106. Now back to Mike and Stu.
You're listening to Sip and Chew with Mike and Stu. And I'm Jonesy Jones. You can find me on YouTube, Jonesy Jones Music. Also, Facebook, Crown Jewels.
Man, it's good hearing from Jonesy during the reggae weekend on the island. You know, headlining down there.
I wish I remembered that. I would have gone yesterday, and the, Roy and them were down there cooking.
Gene Squared from the island's not going to let you live it down. Gabelman. Gabelman.
I guess not. So, anyway.
Man, I'm excited about our guest. And our music, too. But our guest is on now. This is Mikey Chen, the host of Strictly Dumpling. And Mikey, welcome to Alabama if you've never been before. Yeah, we got to get you down here. Mike will take you on a bushwhacker crawl.
Crawling's what you do at the after effect. What do the bushwhackers? But Ron White, the comedian, he's described them as it's like a chocolate milkshake just full of full of alcohol. And you have to drink them at the beach, though. You have to drink them at the beach.
And we got some decent beaches. Some decent beaches.
That sounds dangerous.
Mike, for the listeners who haven't seen your show on YouTube, and that would put them in a small group because you've had a few views on YouTube. What is Strictly Dumpling all about?
Basically, it's a travel food show I think the simplest way to describe it is just me stuffing my face around the world. Essentially, it's a travel food show. I support different cultures. I do a lot of food crawls, I guess, in the U.S. Around the world. In particular, I love Asian food.
Mm-hmm.
So I go to quite a few Asian countries. Go to Europe. Been doing a lot of U.S. stuff lately. But yeah, basically just me stuffing my face and dropping into a deep coma afterwards.
Now, my girlfriend and I ran across your show because we were interested in hot pot. So I typed in and saw where you had done about a 30-minute video with Adam Richman, who Mike and I are both are fans of. And you guys ate this hot pot in New York. And now Mike, my co-host here, who got scared off when we were in L.A. by having to use chopsticks at every meal.
Every meal.
But he's now interested in hot pot. But just to tell you what we did try in L.A. so that you'll be proud of us, Alabama boys, we had dim sum at Bow House of Dim Sum in Beverly Hills. And then we had ramen at a place called Kapan Ramen, also in Beverly Hills.
I think that was my favorite meal out there.
Was it? Yeah. And really? Yeah. And I had heard of these things, and my girlfriend and I had had ramen, and, you know, in college, she grew up on the little packages. But it was...
Yeah, that's where we all started,
huh? Yeah, and then we had black ramen, and just so much out there, and... So she and I are now on this frenzy. We just got a Thai restaurant in the little town we live in. So she's got pho, and I've got my curries. But what do you do for a living other than YouTube that provides you the opportunity to go to all these countries?
We need to know.
Yes.
No, I mean, essentially, this is my full-time job.
There you go, Mike.
I eat for a living. I actually eat for a living.
Oh, yeah. I was a food writer for a while, and that was my job. And I envy you, sir. Now, you hang out with some of the big guys on YouTube. Sean Evans, who, Mike, if you haven't seen Hot Ones with Sean Evans, you've got to. And the burger show you did with Alvin Kalen. Is there a strong, tightly knit community now of you YouTube stars? Like Sean and Alan, and I don't know if you're familiar with the Fung Brothers out in L.A., but I love their show as well.
Yeah, I mean, we in terms of the food community, we all know each other. We don't all hang out all the time, but you know, obviously Sean and Sean's a great guy, Alvin's a great guy. I do know the Fung Brothers. We haven't done anything, but we talk sometimes. So we're not close. But like we know each other, we respect each other, and it's, you know, you share similar passions, so it's definitely something that kind of bonds us. But yeah, and then you have the other YouTube communities that do their own things, and so you know, we kind of know each other, but that's kind of it. We're like in our own little community here.
I don't know how little it is. You've got several million views, don't you?
Yeah, I mean, it's a nice little show. You know, I'm happy people watch, but it's just a great, it is a great opportunity for me because, you know, like growing up, I've always been a fan of food, and my parents own a restaurant, so I was always cooking up something and always stuffing my face there. So it's great to be able to do that as a living. I mean, literally, you know, I have to eat every day anyway, so to be able to make that into a career, awesome.
Well, the other thing that we have noticed is that sometimes you will eat voluminous. You eat a lot of food in a single day, but man, you still seem to stay fit and trim. Are you working out the rest of the time, running and hitting the weights, or just blessed with a nice metabolism?
Well, you know what? It's I feel like it's a lot to do with you know. I credit it to being Asian, like, you see a lot of, well, there's a lot of skinny Asians out there, and my parents are one of them, so I credit them a lot for that. But yeah, now that I'm up there in age a little bit, I work out every single day, sometimes twice, sometimes three times, but, you know, I enjoy working out, so it's something that's good to do. So right now, I'm in Vegas right now, stuffing my face. today I'm hitting, you know, two buffets, so in between, yeah, I'm definitely on the treadmill, but I owe a lot to my parents, so yeah. thank them for giving me a little bit of better metabolism than usual.
Yeah. Well, it also seems like, you know, the whole Asian approach of the yin and yang, the balance that Eastern philosophies always preach about, you're putting in there. If you're eating voluminous amounts of food, you're also working out a lot. There's your balance.
Yeah, no, I'm definitely less and also I'm not as blessed as, I don't know if you guys ever seen like some of these skinny, really skinny little Asian girls just stuffing their face with 8 pounds of rice and eggs or sushi, and they don't even work out. They just sit there like, yeah, I did my meal today, and tomorrow I'll do this again, and I never have to work out. It's like they're flaunting it in your face.
Yeah, now on some of the challenges, you have done some ridiculous didn't you have a 5-pound dumpling?
Yeah, it was a six and a half pound dumpling. Man, that was a rough one. Because you guys ever had a dumpling before, especially a fried dumpling, when that thing gets cold, that
yeah.
is just
idiot. Was this a challenge?
Like a form of torture. So, yeah.
Where was that, Mikey?
What's that? I'm sorry.
Where was that? Was that Singapore?
No, that was Japan.
Japan.
So was this like a challenge, like Alan does, and you get a T-shirt when you eat it all, or?
I don't think they give you a shirt. I think you just get an attaboy or something.
Watching your show and several others, and you know, and even going back to Anthony Bourdain, who really opened up the Western world to a lot of what Southeast Asia has to offer. Right. The street food thing has just got me obsessed. I want to go to Asia, and you can take me, or our good friend Simon Majondar. I want to go with somebody who's familiar with the territory, so that I don't have to do as much research, and just turn me loose in one of those open air markets.
Give him some chopsticks and let him go.
Oh, you guys be, I don't know how adventurous you guys are, but these places are no joke. I mean, you literally have everything that crawls surfed up at these markets and on these street corners. So, I mean, there's some, would you ever eat a an egg that's partially...
I would if someone said it's really delicious. When they say it's an acquired taste, that means it tastes bad, and these people got used to it because it was all they had to survive. And you know, and people might look at us the same way with our crawfish.
Yeah.
So I understand that. I probably would try it. I don't know that it's at the top of my list. It's probably one ahead of, on my list ahead of durian.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I just don't want to smell it.
Fresh.
Yeah, the Fung brothers we were talking about did a durian tasting in Vietnam, I believe it was. And they were remarking how different the different types of durian were. And some of them just, they taste like feet as well as smell like it. And then the other one, they're like, this smells terrible, but it's got the most beautiful flavor. So I guess I could get pushed into durian as well.
Yeah, that's actually, we call that the king of fruits. You know, I guess earned that title because it's good, and also like if you don't like it, someone can just use that to smack you, because that thing was like one of those maize balls with spikes all around it. But it's a great fruit. There's lots of stuff, stinky tofu, lots of very adventurous things that locals absolutely love, but might be a little too much for us, but
yeah,
it's great to explore.
Right, and my girlfriend loves your Everybody Was Tofu Fighting T-shirt. So why don't you tell people where they can get that, where they can see your show, and what's coming up next? Where are you going next?
I have these kind of wacky food T-shirts. You can get it at if you go to any one of my YouTube videos, the link to the store is right down below. And coming up, like I'm in Vegas right now, and I'm going to LA for KCON, which is a Korean convention.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot of fun. And then right after that, I'm going to Uzbekistan.
Oh, wow.
Syria and Afghanistan, and mm-hmm. on the Silk Road. So there's a very historic culture of, you know, food, and the history is beautiful. So it's a very mountainous region. So Can't wait for that. Never been there before.
Ah, that's fantastic. Well, the show is Strictly Dumpling on YouTube. My guess is in the next year or two, Netflix or Amazon, someone's going to come knocking at your door.
We'll see. We'll see. But yeah. Thanks. Hopefully,
yeah. It's happening to a lot of people.
More people watch.
Mikey, it was a pleasure having you on. Man, when you roll out a new episode or something, don't hesitate to drop me a line. We'd love to have you back on to talk about it as long as you're awake.
Yeah, appreciate that, guys. Thanks so much for having me.
Thank you, Mikey. Thanks, Mikey. Mikey Chen from Strictly Dumpling on YouTube. Folks, we got to go to a break here. When we get back, we're going to talk about where we ate.
He's a young guy. I'm looking at him right here now on his page.
Hey, man, listen to that. That's Home Free with Adam Chance from Mobile, Alabama, singing leads.
Woo-hoo. Thank you, Mike.
Oh, we're bringing him back up. Yeah, he's a young guy.
Yeah,
very nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm wanna try everything.
What was that thing you guys talk about, the brothers?
This is Ron McSherry from McSherry's Irish Pub and Restaurant in downtown Fairhope, where you can enjoy great food at a great price, meet your mates for a pint and a chat, or dance the night away with our DJ on Friday and Saturday nights starting at 10. Try our brilliant Blarney Burger, unforgettable Irish potato salad, homemade bread pudding, or it is said the best Reuben sandwich this side of the River Shannon. We open at 3 p.m. and close at 2 a.m. Non-smoking inside, but we have a lovely patio with big screen TVs where you can enjoy all sporting events. Every Sunday at 6 in the evening, we have a traditional Irish music session which attracts musicians from New Orleans to Seaside, Florida. Happy hour is 3 to 6 daily, so be sure to check out our website at www.mcsharries.com for specials. Come on down for a wee taste of Ireland at McSharries Irish Pub in Fairhope, Alabama. You can't miss us. We're the ones with the big leprechaun over the door. 101 North Bank Ross Street on the Eastern Shore. 990-5100. McSharries Irish Pub.
Oh, hello. I didn't see you there. I'm Bob, an apartment home at Legacy Oaks, and I'm so excited my new family is coming by today to get acquainted. I just love having a family to take care of. A lot of folks have been coming in and out, getting me ready, you know, making sure the gas, fireplace, and oven are ready. It's always cozy when my family gathers around the fireplace. I like to give my family plenty of room so everyone has their own space, but it's always nice when we get together in my large eat-in kitchen. And you know, Mom's gonna love the large bath. It's a great place to relax in a large jacuzzi garden tub. I'll even protect the family vehicles with an attached garage. And some of my second floor brothers and sisters even have private elevators. I'm kind of secluded in a large gated community in Spring Hill on Drew Drive with lots of green space. Real convenient to shopping, restaurants, healthcare, and minutes from I-65. There's lots more I can tell you about the amenities here at Legacy Oaks. You know, clubhouse, swimming pool, fitness room. But you can find that out for yourself on the interweb at LegacyOaksApartmentHomes.com. Or you can always call Jimmy. She's real nice. And get a tour at 344-8099. Hey, gotta go. My new family's here. I hope I see you soon. Hey, family. Welcome home.
Does a new building with a wind rating of 175 miles per hour appeal to you? That certainly is within our capability. This is Scott Armstrong with Kemco Metal Buildings. For almost 50 years, Kemco has been designing and constructing the highest quality steel buildings for our customers. Whether you need a building for commercial, industrial, agricultural, storage, church, or community use, or if you just want a Kemco building for yourself, please contact us. Kemco will use state-of-the-art software and our many years of experience to help you custom design a metal building that best suits your needs. Check out our website at KemcoBuildings.com or stop by our 40,000 square foot facility on Baldwin Road in Denver. We're big enough to get the job done and small enough to give you homegrown service. That is KEMKO 251-626-0594.
It really is.
Our goal is to exceed your expectations.
The focus of it is they get
She's the leading educator and retailer of hemp CBD products in South Alabama, and she's on a mission to change the way we look at cannabis. Jennifer Boozer presents Sweet Home Cannabama, a show that will answer all your questions, provide accurate information, and dispel the myths of CBD. With guests from every corner of the hemp industry to advocates for legalization, Jennifer leads the discussion of all things cannabis in Alabama. Join Jennifer Boozer every Monday at 7 p.m. for Sweet Home Cannabama on FM Talk 106.5. To get on the line, call 243-0106.
Look at me. Everybody in charge is younger than me. In the world.
Food Network star, Marty knows Marty's. And you're listening to Biff and Chew with Mike and Stu.
Hey, that's us!
Woo-hoo. Man, we've had two great guests this morning.
Awesome. Yes, we have. You're going to go home and start streaming Mikey's show now, aren't you?
No, I've done.
And I know you watched a few because I
done went on Facebook and liked them
and all the things the kids talk about, huh?
And he can do it while he's co-hosting this show, which is pretty amazing.
That's right, because we use my phone to do the Facebook Live. And we are live on Facebook, folks, as we usually are on Sundays.
Yeah.
You can check out our Facebook page, facebook.com/sipandchew.
It's really
easy. Really easy. We've got a YouTube page as well. Just go into YouTube, type Sip and Chew with Mike and Stu. We'll come right at you.
There you go.
Where'd you eat?
Well, you know, folks,
You want to let Charlie lead it off?
Well, let's let Charlie do his.
Because I'm not reporting on yet another Fern restaurant. Yeah, and we've talked about Neighbor's Restaurant out on Three Notch Road many times.
Good place.
Well, Thursday, my wife and I, Marguerite, decided we would go have lunch at Judy's Place.
Good place.
Up there at Government and Azalea, right across the parking lot from Old Time Pottery. Mm-hmm. Very similar menu, but I kind of hate to say this. I think the food was just a notch better, and the servings were almost more than you could eat. Just great food, and you'll recognize everything on the menu. You don't need an interpreter. And the prices were very reasonable. But I will say, if you're going to lunch, and they're open from like 10 in the morning to 9 at night, so they do lunch and supper. But if you're going to lunch, get there before the 12 o'clock hour, because by the time we finished, we went early. Mm-hmm. It was backing up at the door.
Well, that's every place at noon right now.
Yeah, that is, but Judy's especially. I mean, they outgrew that other building, which there's another restaurant going in that building.
Yeah, a little smaller building over on
Yeah, across the street. It used to be a Wendy's. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, Judy's, that's a great move. And as a matter of fact, Charlie, they just celebrated their 11th year in business and their 1 year anniversary there at the new location.
And Judy was doing the cooking in the kitchen. Mm-hmm.
That's the way it should be. If we call it Judy's. I just kid, Judy.
Where'd you get?
Well, it was my birthday, and I didn't want any.
71.
I didn't want anything big and whatever, and I was hankering for a steak.
Steak.
So we went to Texas Roadhouse. Mm-hmm. Did
they have ferns in the lobby?
No.
I've talked to some people that work at Texas Roadhouse. They have a very good program going on with their steaks. They butcher them in-house.
Mm-hmm. And they put them on display up front. You could actually pick out one if you want to.
Right. And so when I do a fern bar or a chain restaurant, I like to, as we've talked about before, I like to go to places that get it. Bonefish Grill gets it.
Yeah.
It sounds like Texas Roadhouse gets it. Mm-hmm. Tejas de Brazil that you were talking about with John, they absolutely get it.
I've got to go there. I haven't been, but I got to go.
It is phenomenal.
But
sign up for, and this is a tip for the listeners as well, you can sign up for a newsletter, email newsletter from Texas de Brazil. They don't bombard you, maybe one a week. Mm-hmm. Every now and then they'll have some fantastic specials in that email. Mm-hmm. When Heather and I tried it, it was just for people who were members.
Yeah.
Sign up. Hey, this is our 20th anniversary, I think it was, or 25th. We're rolling our prices back to what they were when we opened in 1987. And that was the night we went and tried them.
Yeah.
So instead of it being $45, which still is a good price for what you get.
Right.
Because it is exquisite. It was $25. Mm-hmm. And they have stuff like that all the time. Did you go anyplace else?
I did. 219 downtown. I had a wedge.
Oh.
I had a wedge salad. He has one of the best wedge salads you'll find.
And who's he again?
Todd Henson, who owns 219. It's catty corner from Sanger, the Sanger, right there, Kata and Joachim, I think.
Yeah, Joachim Conti.
What is wedge salad?
It's a piece of...
It's a wedge of iceberg lettuce.
They just cut it like a quarter of it out of an iceberg lettuce, and they just
dredge it in blue cheese and bacon.
Okay, so it's a chunk.
Yeah,
it's a chunk.
Shaped like a wedge.
Yep.
Okay. Well,
cleared that up. Thank
Heather
you.
Treated me yesterday to Sabai. So mm-hmm. they've been open 4 weeks. We've been there twice.
Mm-hmm.
I did eat the Fairhope Market because I'm cooking there.
Yeah.
And, man, we got some good stuff going on.
I ate there, too.
Yeah, I saw you. John from Fish River was in at least 4 days this week.
Yeah, I got to get the fried chicken. I hear good things about the fried chicken.
Yeah, that's Chris's. Chris Sherrill doing that fried chicken. Nourish Cafe, Heather brought me some of Garrick's. I don't know if it's vegan or vegetarian or what, but it is pimento cheese, and it is great.
Hey.
Yeah. And then she also brought me some of her sandwich from the Cheese Cottage.
Oh, wow.
That was just fantastic. But that pimento cheese that Garrick did at Nourish Cafe, he only ran it last week. Mm-hmm. You're probably out. So you got to subscribe to Nourish Cafe on Facebook to know when they're doing it again.
Yeah.
But it's good stuff.
Now, if you want to get a good pimento cheese all the time, go to Le Bichon Wine Bar.
Oh, absolutely.
Daphne and get David's pimento cheese. Yeah. It's awesome.
Hey, can I ask you a burning question?
Sure.
Are you guys revolting against the Burger King Impossible Burger?
Yeah.
It's supposed to be it's supposed to be like all vegetarian.
Are there Burger
Kids? Here's my thing. If you are a vegetarian or vegan and you're giving up food for one of these reasons, you know, meat, then stop asking for a burger. You've got to give up all of it. If you're eating a so-called veggie burger, you're a hypocrite.
Well, but they also have a disclaimer saying that it's cooked on the same grill as the hamburger patty. So
yeah,
so you're still getting some of that.
Yeah, because I'm not about to put a special grill in to cook your tofu burger.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I will never serve a veggie burger as long as I have control over the menu. If you want vegetables, eat a salad.
Wendy's. Bunless burger.
What about if an animal defecates on the grass or a plant that eventually turns into vegetarian food?
That's why they irradiate all of it. Blasted all with gamma. Cookie, I'm sorry we didn't get to you, dear. We just had so much packed in the show today.
You lose.
Folks, get out there, support local, be local, buy local.
Yeah.
Tip your servers. Servers earn your tips.
Yeah.
And Stu?
Yes, sir.
You going to go eat Asian food again today?
No, I got to go to Fairhope Market and cook brunch.
Okay, well, have a good time, man.
All right. Provolone.
Provolone, folks.
Provolone. Great show, guys.
Thank you.
You got to figure out a way to get paid for it.
Hello, baby.
Make a living out of it.
This is Big Papa speaking.
Hey, bring me one in donuts.
This is true.
All right, now, y'all. I got to get down to Fairhope Market so y'all get.